We buy products based on other people's opinions. On Amazon, if you don't have a lot of reviews, I am most likely not going to buy your product. Because for me, it signifies a couple of things. Number one, demand.
Yeah.
The higher the review count, the more demand it has. And I like to use things that have high demand. It signifies success.
All right, guys, we are here to talk about review strategies.
That's right. I would like you to have some proof that your brand has something of value.
Yeah.
And that proof is reviews. And that's why it's important. People believe others, they don't believe the brand itself. The brand will say anything to try to get them to sell, to buy the products.
Sure.
But other people's opinions have a lot of weight. The most powerful strategy that has revolutionized e-commerce is the onset of reviews. The beginning of that era of sharing other people's opinions about a product, and Amazon protecting that particular concept of like not manipulation of reviews and actual authentic opinions about a product really do determine. People like myself and like you, we buy products based on other people's opinions. On Amazon, if you don't have a lot of reviews, I am most likely not going to buy your product, because for me, it signifies a couple of things. Number one, demand.
Yeah.
The higher the review count, the more demand it has. And I like to use things that have high demand. It signifies success. It's like if you walk into an empty restaurant, just think about that. Same thing. You walk into an empty restaurant, you're like, why is this place empty?
Totally.
This must be like garbage food.
My parents taught me that. Don't go to a restaurant if it's empty.
That's right.
The
you walk in,
are the busy ones.
Immediately you're concerned about it.
Yeah.
And now you're like second guessing what you're going to order because yeah. Nobody else is ordering, right?
Yeah.
But then if you walk into a bustling, like
I would rather wait for a good restaurant than eat bad food.
It's the same concept, right? Like you go into a review, into a listing that has reviews, you see volume, you see demand, and that demand immediately gets you into the consumer mindset. There must be something special here.
Yeah.
But now you wanna open up those reviews, and other people's opinions will determine whether you buy a product or not. It's just the way it is. It's an important aspect of this. Before we actually start going heavy on generating reviews, we need one thing before that. What do we need, Rob?
More sales.
We need more sales.
Yeah.
And in order for us to get sales, do we go to e-commerce and promote our products to people that don't know who we are?
No.
It's not gonna work. People are not gonna buy it. You're gonna come back to me and tell me, Manuel, I spent $10,000 and I got no sales, because there's too much competition out there.
Yeah.
If you wanna tell me that story about, you know, going in a time machine and go 12 years ago, then the answer is yes, you will get product sales no matter what, because the supply and demand was very different than what it is right now.
Yeah.
So right now you have to do whatever it takes. If you have to go to your neighbor and have these things with you physically, and you can show them, hey, listen, neighbor, we've been neighbors for 12 years.
Yeah.
I'm comfortable having you as my neighbor, and I think you are comfortable having me as a neighbor, and I just want to say thank you. I mean, if you been a mean neighbor that never talks to them, then that door is going to get shut in your face. But if you've been friendly, and if you talk to them over the years, and if you said hi to each other, then I would listen to you.
Yeah.
I would listen to my neighbor.
Yeah.
And my neighbor comes to me. That's why communication is senior, right?
Yes.
Because if you feel unable to communicate to people, then I cannot help you. I can't help you. But if you have the willingness to communicate, you go to your neighbor. Rob is my neighbor. Hey, Rob. Can I get a minute of your time?
Sure.
I know we've been neighbors for like 12 years, man.
Yeah.
You know, I'm sorry that my dogs have come into your yard.
That's totally fine.
Over and over again, man.
No problem.
Yeah.
I just call and it gets handled.
Okay, good. True story. That's what happens with my dogs. They invade the neighbor's house all the time. But the neighbors, they love me. I mean, that guy would do anything for me.
I believe it.
I would. No, he's come to the grand opening of the building.
Wow.
He was here. His name is John.
Is that the same one that sent his daughters to be interns?
That's the other neighbor.
A different neighbor. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So imagine how crazy I am with getting along with people, right?
Yeah.
So I live in a street that has like mansions, right? You can imagine. Like I'm the ninja, guys. Like I walk the talk, right?
Nice
so
house. Nice house.
You've been to my house, Rob.
Nice house.
So on one side, I got a neighbor. They are one of them is a surgeon and the other one is a general doctor.
Wow.
And they love me so much that they send the two daughters to do an internship on marketing over
brilliant
here.
Girls.
And they spent a few months over here.
Yeah, brilliant.
Doing an internship.
Yeah.
they would do anything that I asked them to do.
Yeah.
That's how much they appreciate me. On the other side, and we don't get to hang out, by the way, we just have goodwill. We just get along. We're comfortable having each other, like next to each other, right? And on the other side, I have an old couple. They're like in their 80s, sweethearts, 80 something years old. Same as John. The wife's name is Anne.
Okay.
Been neighbors for years. He would do anything that I ask him to do. He would do it willingly.
Wow.
And even though we're not like family or nothing, I will walk in and let me tell you exactly how I would say it. All right. You ready for this?
Yeah.
Let's role play.
I'm here.
We did not coordinate this.
We
right?
did not.
I'm going to have this in my pocket. All right.
I'm being John, right? I'm being the neighbor.
This is the antioxidant toner. Good Luck Nutrition, which by the way, you guys can sell if you want it. Neighbor, how's it going, John?
It's going good. Yeah, good to see you, man.
That's great, man. I'm here today to ask you for your help.
Sure.
This is not very unusual. I know we've been neighbors for like several years and I've never asked you for anything.
Yeah. You want me to watch the dogs for you or something?
Well, no. They're going to come and visit you
anyway,
without permission. Without permission. They come all the time, right?
True.
But John, let me ask you for a favor. You have an Amazon account?
I do. Yeah.
Okay.
Anne uses the account. I just ask for things.
That's accurate.
Yeah.
That's accurate. Yeah. I mean, I've seen some boxes coming in here sometime and I figure that you have Amazon.
That's true.
Just like 90% of the population
That's
does.
True.
Yeah. John, I launched a new brand.
Very cool.
Yes. And I'm excited about it.
Okay.
Because it's going to help a lot of people that are looking to protect their skin. It is an anti-aging brand.
That's cool.
Yeah. I'm asking for help. I'm not offering. I am not soliciting. I am saying, help me, neighbor.
Yeah.
That's just the way it is. You see how it requires like, there's this word called confront, right? You got to be able to talk to people.
Yeah.
If you feel like, oh no, I'm scared of people, then building a brand is going to be a big time challenge for you.
Yeah.
Anyways, you got to be willing to talk to people, communicate to people. So I'm like, John, so I want to show you, and I'm going to give you this sample.
Is this your product?
This is my product.
Okay,
it's called antioxidant toner.
Very nice.
I mean, you're already a good-looking guy.
Well, thank you.
But I think this is going
to
help.
Anne likes to use this kind of stuff on her skin, so I'm not sure what...
It's natural.
Natural?
100% natural.
Wow, okay,
yeah,
cool.
100%. I mean, if you look at the ingredients, it's like aloe vera, leaf juice organic.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a bunch of like super awesome, high-quality stuff that we put together in one product.
Very nice.
Actually, you can use it two to three times a day.
Okay.
I want to ask you for a favor, though.
Yeah.
I'm giving you this free bottle.
Well, thank you.
Could you do me a favor? And if I send you a link to your phone, can you give it to Anne and have her purchase one bottle?
Sure.
For me, I would appreciate it. I'm going to give you a special link.
Yeah.
And just so you know, John, the main reason why I'm doing this is because my friends and family are the first ones that I ask for help to help me promote this brand and purchasing it first. And then in a week or two, I'm going to ask you if you can leave an unbiased review about it.
I would love to help you out.
And maybe Anne can do it. Maybe I can, I'll give you a special link. All she has to do is click on it.
Yeah.
And then she'll write some words about it, about what she felt or how she felt or how, I don't know, John, maybe you guys really like it. If you communicate to him and if you have a real intention, he's going to want to help.
Yeah.
So if you, whether you do a phone call, you send a text, you send an email, you communicate to your neighbors, you go to a club and you ask people for help.
Yeah.
And no matter what that is, your goal should be, let's get 50 of these people to purchase it.
Yeah.
Because if you get 50 of them and you just get half of them to help you with reviews, you got 25 reviews of a product now.
Yeah.
And now whenever you start sending traffic to your website, they can now start looking at other people's opinions. Without that, you should not be running any sort of advertising.
That makes sense.
Does that make sense?
Totally makes sense. Absolutely.